Right, right. Yeah, he also had a pretty good run in Smash and Splash. I believe he made it to 17th or 13th place, taking out Pow Pow from Wisconsin, a Sonic player in the process. And that, I mean, if you know anything about that matchup, dude, woo, that is awful. But Pow Pow's my boy, so shout-outs to him. I don't mean to put you on blast like that for dropping a set to him, but I absolutely would get mauled by Zaki's DDD regardless of who I played, so I can't even say anything.
Yeah.
Rags, though, maybe has a better chance after, like you mentioned, his legendary run to 7th place at Smash and Splash, defeating Cosmos, Ally. Did he beat Captain Zack at that tournament, too?
No,
that was at Glitch.
Yeah, he's
a killer.
Yeah, lots of good wins, so very excited to see how these two are going to play out. I think Rags had a couple of close calls. I remember hearing people saying, like, I should have beaten Rags or something like that. But here we go. These two are just going to go ahead and get things started out. I am very curious, if I'm going to be honest, how Zaki is going to play any of these matchups, since we don't really get to see this character all too much. So
DDD is the forgotten lord of Smash 4. When the game came out, you know, people thought he was pretty decent, myself included. I used to main the character. Mm-hmm. And yeah, we just slowly learned over time that he was not so great. And then I've heard in the past couple months or even the past year, whispers of him being potentially the worst character in the game. Mm-hmm. Zaki has something to say about that, I would say.
Very sure.
Top 128 winners here out of 780 entrants.
Mm-hmm. But looks like so far, Rack's not having too hard of a time being able to get these up air setups across the stage, and he's not going to be able to find that nair. But I feel like Meta Knight, just with his speed, is able to quickly burst option against a character like this, and he's just doing a fantastic job against Zaki so far.
Yeah, not only can he just rip right through all your walling strategies, but once he hits you, he really makes it count. DDD being a heavy fast faller with a huge body, so easy to combo. Of course, he'll survive Shuttle Loop longer than anyone else because of his physics, but also the up air will convert into it at longer percent ranges than anyone else too.
This man just went for it, and it felt like Rags. If he didn't pick it up,
he's dead. That went backwards. Why? How? By the way, if you hit with the hammer into the Gordo, that does, I think, 30-something percent. It's a lot of damage.
That was crazy. He went the other way, and then he threw in the down tilt, or the crouch from DDD to boot. But, yep, just going to close it up with another shuttle loop, but you can already feel the crowd just exerting their energy for Zaki here.
Yeah, I think Smash 4 has a new fan favorite. And hey, what a time, as the game is in its closing months. He's going to be remembered as the last great hero of low tiers.
Yeah. Alrighty. Just going to retreat back to the legend. That's something we saw against MKLeo the other day, was Zaki with the DDD's multiple jumps and his long hammer was able to mix up how he got back to the legend and kept MKLeo on his toes. But it looks like Rack's not falling for any of that. Is he going to get that combo on the platform? Not enough treadmill to get the ladder combo started, but just going to take him to the other side of the stage.
Yeah, DDD, a character with possibly one of the worst disadvantage states in the game, but he's still able to make it work. Just a little bit of sleight of hand with his jumps, and then he'll swing when you least expect it, possibly protect himself with a Gordo on the way down, all the way from up in the magnifier. I've seen Zaki do some crazy stuff, but patient play and smart reads can generally dismantle this character, especially if you're a little bit familiar. Yes, catching the loop. Meta Knight leaves himself open if you don't perfectly sweet spot your recovery. Oh, and he's looking for the rolls. MKLeo fell for that, but Rag's saying, no, I'm taking the high road, fam.
All right, let's
see. Oh, and no, he's not. Exiting stage left right there. Zaki going to close out game one. That move is, I think, 13-ish frames. It's not that fast, especially for a sweeping down smash. Generally,
well, it's pretty fast for DDD standards,
yes,
let's be real.
Yes, exactly.
Yeah, I think it definitely caught. Zaki is enjoying himself way too much right now, just giving thumbs up to the camera. He's just like, yep, I know. I play a very bad character, but I'm doing fantastic right now.
This dude just looks like he has a lot of fun when he plays Smash, and I think that's one of the most important things. If you're just focused on enjoying yourself, you're not going to choke or drop a set that you should win. You're just out here having fun.
Yep. And that's one of those things, is when you get a down throw rar back, there's so much damage. And you're going to go ahead and get that body slam. And another one! So much damage already onto Rags.
By the way, I must point out that because Zaki defeated MKLeo, he's technically usurped the first seed of this tournament. Mm-hmm. So he actually has the easiest bracket going forward, technically. He will be fighting the lowest seeded opponents. Oh, and Rags actually not able to close that stock. If he had gone for a full drift jumping C-stick nair, it might have been enough to close it out. But might have doubted his execution in the moment of truth, just gone for the easier forward air.
Mm-hmm. All right, let's see how he makes it back to the stage. Just a quick landing, not able to make it back from the ledge, though. Tries to go for the inhale, but the hitbox from the dash attack beats it out.
Yeah, DDD's options, although few in number, actually serve pretty different purposes on the way down. You know, he's got a command grab to beat shield. He has fairly big aerials to beat you swinging on him. But still, if you're really on the ball, you're not going to let this character land or get back from the edge. Let's see what Rags has this time.
Ooh, just calls it out on whiff and able to get that landing back air. And that's what we saw with Zaki against MKLeo too. Just able to cash so many things on whiff and just get a huge punish. Because DDD just needs one good hit to be able to seal out the kill. Let's see what he does here.
Oh, I don't know if that neutral air was intentional. I think falling up air might have been the choice. Maybe C-Stick Nair unintentionally there.
Yeah.
Not sure, but either way, these players dead even right now. A single percent separating them. And here we are on Dreamland, by the way. Home nation of these two.
Yeah, definitely got the lore matchups going in here. And you can tell Rags, he's...
Oh, no! How did you fall for that? How? Rags, wake up, man! Is this Elegant Part 2? I mean, the set's a lot longer, but still.
Oh, man, you got to give Rags some credit, though. I mean, this man, he knows that Zaki's just going to be continuously throwing out those hitboxes at the ledge, and he's trying to avoid those and get a reversal around them. But then Zaki just hits him with a huge mix-up, and he can't do anything about it. He didn't know that was coming.
Zaki going for a grimy setup into that down air. Rags not going to give him the air dodge he wants, though. And all of a sudden, this match still even. Oh, what? He doesn't know what to do. How could you? How many DDDs do you think Rags has fought in his time playing Smash 4?
I'm willing to bet maybe three.
Yeah, he's got J-Dog down there, and I don't know any other DDDs from MDVA. But still, you cannot possibly have come prepared for this fight.
Not at all. But here we go. Just down throw up air. Got a little bit of pressure with the Gordo. Gets the grab in and get a quick
release. Oh! Is he dead? No, not quite, but still.
he's fishing, man. This penguin has turned into a
not
shark.
Not again. Okay, thank God. But Rags, one of the best at converting off of those Meta Knight up air strings. Unfortunately, not going to get it. The super armor getting DDD back to the edge safely. Rags knows he's a dash attack away, but rolls right into that Zaki with the psychic type reads.
All right, that's two for two. Two down smashes to end two games so far. This man's crazy. He's off the wall right
he's
now.
He's channeling Brawl Meta Knight with these down smashes here.
Oh, man. You can already see the crowd is just absolutely enjoying this show. We got one more game left for Zaki to advance on into the further halves of the bracket.
And Rags with a little bit of a smirk on himself. I would say he's in relatively high spirits. If you lose to this guy, especially fresh off his win against Leo, you can't be too mad.
Yeah, you can't feel too bad about it. It's like, if even the best player in the world is going to fall for it, then it should be okay.
All right. Got an intense standoff by the edge. I feel like half of last game was spent at the edge. DDD so easy to ledge trap, but Zaki so crafty at actually making it happen. Mm-hmm. He's able to return to the stage more easily than I've seen players with top-tier characters do it.
Yeah. All right, let's see what he does here. He's playing cat and mouse with a giant fat penguin, and I think that's actually astounding because Rags is having a really difficult time catching him. That's just how smart Zaki's playing, knowing exactly what Rags is trying to do.
All these fake-outs! Oh, this guy is ridiculous! A huge penguin with a huge brain! If you're not a fan of Zaki, I don't know what to tell you. You must just be one of those people that hates everything. Oh, and he goes for it! Super deep off the stage. Gonna close out the first stock. Faster than I think any stocks in this set have ended. They've played a relatively patient neutral, but this time Zaki just going right in. Invincibility gonna expire. He's looking for the down air and he gets it! Is he dead? Yes! Rags eliminated from the face of the earth by the King Zaki himself!
I have no words. That was... Rags just picked the absolute worst mix-ups to do at that very moment. Like, Zaki was hovering right above him. He was like, okay, come on, do it, do it. I know you're gonna side B. And just completely intercepted it and took out two stocks in pretty much less than a minute. That was crazy.
And the entire crowd, Japanese and American alike, erupting for their new king. Let's go, Zaki! Let's go, Zaki!